Hallelujah. We are very glad to have you in this place. uyu mwanya
this time
tugiye kwibuka indirimbo z'imurenge.
We are going to remember the kind of songs. We are going to have drums beaten and amapendo. The young people are not used to this kind of songs or this kind of
playing.
This is for all the people, ladies and gentlemen, please come forward so that we can
hear.
We are going to welcome the choir from Lubbock, Texas.
With
the one number of songs, please.
Hey, Beka, 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 beka. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Muri akibira marino kuse.
Amen.
We're
reading from verse 4. Data yagenye n'ubutware bwe wenyine icyakora muzahabwa imbaraga umwuka wera n'abamanukira kandi muzabagaho kumpamya Yerusalemu Yudaya yose ni Samariya no kugeza ku mpera y'isi. Amaze kuvuga atyo azamurwa bakimureba igicu kiramubakingiriza. Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, and being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me, and for John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? And he said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons which the Father has put in his own authority, but you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Now when he had spoken these things, while they watched, he was taken up in a cloud, received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by in white apparel.
Kumurongo wa 12 basubiri Yerusalemu bavuye ku musozi witwa Elayono uri bugufi kw'i Yerusalemu nk'urugendo rwo kugendwa ku isabato. Basohoyeyo barurira baja mu cyumba cyo hejuru aho Petero na Yohana na Yakobo na Andreya na Filipo na Toma na Bartolomayo na Matayo na Yakobo mwene Alufayo na Simoni Zelote na Yuda mwene Yakobo babaga. Abo bose hamwe n'abagore na Mariya nyina wa Yesu na bene se bakomeza gusengana umutima uhuye. Amen.
Verse 12, then they returned to Jerusalem from Mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey. And when they had entered, they went up into the upper room where they were staying, Peter, James, John, and Andrew, Philip, and Thomas, Bartholomew, Matthew, James, the son of Alphaeus, Simeon the Zealot, and Judas, the son of James. These all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers.
Yesu yabyaye itorero.
Jesus birthed the church.
Yesu yavuze ngo nzubaka itorero.
He is the one who said, I will build my church.
Nzaryubaka ku rutare.
I will build it on the rock.
Yesu niwe rutare.
Jesus is the rock.
Itorero rya Kristo ryubakwa n'ubumenyi revelation y'Imana.
The church of Christ is built by the knowledge of the revelation of God.
Petero amaze guhishurirwa Yesu.
So when Peter had received the revelation of Jesus, then he was told that the church was going to be built. So for the church to be built, we need to download the mind of God and what he wants, what he wills is what we put in his work. When you work in a factory somewhere, that factory is owned by someone. Now that person has the mind for that company. They will employ people who meet what they want to achieve. And they need to know the space that they're working in, the needs that need to be met in that factory. I was told that there is a factory that works on meat. So people here in Amarillo working in that factory know the amount of people they need to supply the meat products. So when they employ people, they do so according to the demands they have. So meat has to be brought in. There are people who have to prepare the meat. There are people who have to process it and sell it. So all of that comes from the mind of the factory. And that person has people to do what he wills. So now it's a factory of meat. And meat comes through machines. The way you have to cut the meat. And the way it has to be put in boxes. You don't need to study that in school. But you need to have skills, knowledge of skills. You need to know how it works and do it. So the owner of the factory doesn't need someone who went to school, doesn't need someone who speaks English, because in his plan they want someone who can stand for 8 hours and do the hard work. That's the person they need. When he gets many, he could send much more meat produce abroad. So if you have been given the task